Do-it-yourself solar is cheaper than big rooftop solar systems. My setup is 600 watt for 900 euros. That's 15 euro cent per kilowatt hour in 10 years. And you can plug it straight into your wall with a micro inverter. With plug and play, you can start with a small solar system on your balcony, and it supports the dishwasher, the fridge, and everything. But here's the twist. I'll show you how you can store your excess energy instead of feeding it into the public grid for free, or worse, you're paying for it. Hi, I'm Norbert. I'm an energy engineer. In video number 100, I'll show you how to do this. Start small but serious solar systems and expand later. Use microinverters to feed the whole house. Store energy safely and legally with a DIY battery system. Let's make sure that your solar system reduces your bills, not just decorate your roof. The rules are changing and PV owners are getting mad. Calm down, be like water and flow around the rock. You will slowly erode it. Normal inverters power just one outlet. And microinverters, they feed into the whole house, helping all devices. Even if two panels give only 500 watts, it will reduce the power that you buy from the grid. So for example, from your washing machine pulling 2000 watts at the moment, your solar cuts that down to 1500. Clean. Clever savings. Sunny day, not home, then your excess solar goes back to the grid, to the public grid. No worry, this microinverter is fully certified to be connected to your grid. But the problem is, for the electricity that goes outside, you get no money, or very little. But some meters charge you anyway, because they are not made to read the direction of the flow. Well, let's fix that. Let's catch that power before it escapes. Most microinverters can't store energy. I've built a safe DIY system. It stores solar in a battery. Later, or also on the moment, you feed it into your house when you need it. You control it with a manual switch for now. No unwanted feed-in into the public grid. But you must be there to flip the switch if there's no consumption. In next videos, we will make this automatic. I think it's already a big step that you can even do it. This is fully modular. You are free to choose your parts and save money. If you like this idea, then like and subscribe. Share this with friends that are tired of disappointing tariffs and changing rules. We solve it ourselves, peacefully. This setup here gives you control. Use solar now or charge a battery. Flip a switch to power your house later. Limit the power to protect your battery and your inverter. I used a Hoy Miles HM600 with two independent inputs for 300 volt panels at 24 volts, which is a common voltage for that power. Two car batteries that give a voltage between 24 to 28 volts to reach over the inverter's minimal operation voltage. And then a car lamp as a safety resistor. It's like a built-in PTC, positive temperature coefficient. It limits the current when it gets high and is therefore inherently safe in case of a runaway. Now, the batteries will absorb your excess energy and give it back, while others have to purchase that energy from the grid. During blackouts, microinverters stop. Yes, but also big rooftop systems fail. Our system in Sicily will even stop to charge the batteries. My fixed 50 euro inverter connected to the same battery. It gives 1.5 kilowatt during outages. So when the grid fails, you have still power and peace of mind. 1. The solar panel goes to the charge controller. From there, the battery charges during the day, or the solar power goes directly to the microinverter. And then flip the switch and the home gets battery power. And in case of a blackout, you use your second inverter. Done. You are in control. And here's my shopping list. You see it. 900 euros. And in 10 years, you can collect 6,000 kilowatt hours. And divide that, and then you get 15 euro cents per kilowatt hour. You need energy. Get independent. Are you also looking, Charlie? Let's see if we can sit here. Yeah, a full weight is on it. And also the weight of the 5 kilo of Charlie. So, now we are 90 kilos on these two wires, and I think I touched it to put this panel on it.